Okay, hello everyone. Let us now proceed to the homogeneous linear equations. Okay, so to start, we must learn the superposition principle. Now, this superposition principle is a key concept in constructing the general solution of a homogeneous linear nth order differential equation. Okay, so before tackling the superposition, it's like a tongue twister. A superposition principle. It's important to know what a linear combination is. A linear combination of functions. Okay, so let's say we have two functions. F1 of x is equal to x. And we have f2 of x is equal to x squared. So the linear combination of these two functions is y is equal to c1. C1 being an arbitrary constant multiplied by x multiplied by c2, another arbitrary constant, then x squared. So this is the linear combination of these two functions. Okay? So what if we have three? What if we have three functions? So let's say we have f3x is equal to, let's say, x cubed na lang. Okay? So what is our linear combination then? So that would be plus c3 x cubed. Okay, so the general form of a linear combination is y is equal to c1 and then f1 of x plus c2 f2 of x plus ... and then plus fn of x. Okay, so that is the linear combination of the n number of functions that you have. Okay, so that is what you call a linear combination. Okay, so now that we know what a linear combination is, let us now go to the definition of the superposition principle. Okay, so let y1, y2, until yk be solutions of a homogeneous nth order differential equation on an interval I. So this is a homogeneous linear nth order differential equation interval I. Then the linear combination y is equal to c1 y1 of x plus c2 y2 of x all the way to ck yk of x or cn yn of x, where ci, where I is equal to 1, 2 until k, are arbitrary constants, is also a solution. Is also a solution on the interval. Okay, so the linear combination, so diba, we have y1 y2 yk y number. If k is equal to 3, then we have three solutions. Then the superposition principle says that the linear combination of those n number of solutions is also a solution in itself to that particular homogeneous linear nth order differential equation. Okay, so let's take a look at an example. We have right here the differential equation x squared and then y double prime minus xy prime plus y is equal to 0. And it says that we are given here the solution. So we have not tackled yet how to determine this solution. So we will do that in the later sections and in later lessons. But for now, we are given the solutions y is equal to x and y is equal to x ln x. So these are the two solutions. Okay, there are two solutions because this is a second order differential equation. Okay, so from the superposition principle, we can then say that the linear combination of these two functions, of these two solutions, is also a solution. So therefore, y is equal to c1x plus c2x ln x is also a solution of this differential equation. Okay, so that is what the superposition principle means. And there are also implications of this theorem. Okay, we can derive some implications of this theorem or corollaries. So a multiple y is equal to c1 y1 of x is of a solution y of a solution y1 of x of a homogeneous linear equation is also a solution. Okay, so let's apply this to our example. We have here a solution, for example, y is equal to x, right? So the fact that that is a solution, then we can also say that y is equal to cx. Okay, cx is also a solution. So cx is also a solution where c is any arbitrary constant. Okay, and a homogeneous linear differential equation always possesses a trivial solution of y is equal to zero. So a homogeneous, so it's actually self-explanatory. So if your differential equation is a homogeneous linear differential equation, then it always has the trivial solution of y is equal to zero because of the right-hand side of our equation is zero. Okay, so that's it for the superposition principle. And I hope you learned something new today. Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.